back here in Rupert, and this is one of the funnest gatherings we've been to. I'm a 4-H group, and they challenged me to write a poem before the end, and I did, and it was about winning the buckle, and sure enough, I did end up winning that buckle. And I'd like to thank Chris Martinson for coming on the buckle. An old timer was walking through a candy museum to reminisce of days gone by when a case of tarnished buckles sparked a memory and caught his eye. He stopped and paused for a moment. He thought he remembered something right then of the long ago 4-H group rode together, growing and trying to become men. They were learning about cattle, horses from the cowboy ways. His eyes seemed to cloud as his mind drifted back to those forgotten days. He was just a lad, his excitement was grand as he thought about his good luck. Climbed the fence, his heart about to burst as he got rid of that old buck. That old buckskin was keen and ready to run. His days were not up just yet. He'd take care of the boy and teach him to ride. He wasn't just any backyard pet. Oh, the things that they saw, the work that they did, and the miles that they shared. The boy and his part chasing cattle and dreams, they couldn't have been a better pair. He thought of the pledge and the words that they'd say, together every week. Head, heart, hands, and health. The 4-H soon became something he'd seek. He worked and practiced and did his best to learn all that he should about ranching and roping and doctoring too, sometimes wondering if he could. Then one day the boss had some news. At the end of the summer, there'd be a big day. A competition of sorts to show off all their skills, and a shiny buckle would be the pay. That night he couldn't sleep. His yearning was real, his buckle was unlike any other kind. He gave it his all, lay it all on the line, when the buckle was on his mind. His eyes brightened up as the thought came to him, as he asked to open the case. He picked up the buckle, turned it over in his hand, as a smile crept over his face. And there on the back of the first place award, was an inscription written just for him. Congratulations from old Buck and Dad on your very first buckle win. A withered hand trembled as he held this memory and thought, it made me who I am, learning cowboy, 4-H's, a loop and a hoss, so I